Devotional, and it was quiet, and it was the Spirit. It was so powerful. It was structured, and we take our faith seriously, but we don't take ourselves too seriously. And today we're going to dance, right? So we got third grade getting ready. We have an announcement. We have a very special announcement. So listen up. You ready for this announcement? On Monday, masks become optional at all places on campus, at all K-12 schools in Utah. You can choose. We're not encouraging or discouraging, so for those of you who still choose to continue wearing a mask, you may. But the governor issued that press release today. So thank you, all of you. Students, thank you for your perseverance and your patience. Parents, thank you too. It's been a long year. We're gonna dance that year away right now. Okay, let's begin with a prayer, which is gonna be offered by Mrs. Reed, our kindergarten teacher. Come on over, Mrs. Reed, thank you. If you've never been to our dance festival, it is a celebration of peoples and cultures around the world. We love it. Let's make sure to, while they're dancing, give them plenty of support with clapping and cheering. This is one of our highest energy events of the year. This is not a devotional. I repeat, this is not a devotional. Okay, with that, let's have a prayer.
Our dear kind Heavenly Father, we're so very grateful for this beautiful day, and we're thankful for this chance we have to gather as a school and to celebrate dance and to have fun together. We're thankful for all the preparations that have gone into it and all the hands that have helped. We ask that Thou will help us all to be brave and to be happy and to cheer each other on. We love Thee, Father, and pray these things, and we say these things in the name of Thy Son, Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen.
And now we'll turn the time over to Art McCumber in our dance department, who is our MC. Let's give him a big round of applause.
All right, let's hear it for the headmaster, Mr. Grant Beckwith. It's because the founders of this school love dance so much that we get to have the barn program and the folk dancing program. We get to have this wonderful event. We're so glad you're here today. And without any further ado, let's just kick this baby off. Third grade class is going to dance for you the Maypole Dance, which hails from Germany. And it's a dance that says goodbye to winter and ushers in spring. So third grade class, let's go.
Thank you.
let's hear it for our third grade classes. Yeah. If we had about a half an hour, that whole poem looked gorgeous. Would you stick it right in the entry to the school? They didn't miss a beat. All right, this next dance we've got for you is from our fourth grade class. I'm looking around to see if there's stage. Here they come. They got the cowboy hats on, so you probably know what this song is going to be. This song goes way back, started way back before the Civil War. And it is a crowd favorite. They are getting in position. I see some good looking hats. I might want to trade hats with somebody. All right, fourth graders look like they're in position. Folks, let's give a big round of applause for our fourth graders as they dance for you to Cock Eyed Joe.
If it hadn't been for Cock Eyed Joe, I'd been married a long time ago. Where did you come from? Where did you go? Where did you come from, Cock Eyed Joe?
Should have told you folks, they actually choreographed that dance, and I have not seen that dance like that ever. That was fantastic. Way to go, fourth grade class. All right. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, if I could have your attention, please. Boys and girls, we get a lot of very special visitors to American Heritage School, but I don't know if we've ever had someone this special before. We've got royalty visiting today. In fact, this gentleman is probably responsible for the mascot being the Patriots of this school. Because of this individual, a couple of years ago, our founding father said, enough of this, we're heading out west. We're going to that new land. Yeah, folks, we've got a very special person here today. So without any further ado, let me introduce to you our eighth grade class led by the one and only King George III.
Not a price that you're willing to pay. You cry in your tea, which you hurl in the sea when you see me go by. Why so sad? Remember, we made an arrangement when you went away. Now you're making me mad. I will fight the fight and win the war for your love, for your praise, and I'll love you till my dying day. When you're gone, I'll go ahead, tell your girl the way to stay with her. Cause when push comes to shove, I will end your friends and family to remind you of my love. Da 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 da.
So blessed to have such great talent, aren't we? Fantastic. This next dance, ladies and gentlemen, is always a crowd favorite. It's called the Makulele, and it pays honor to a young boy who was part of a Brazilian sugarcane plantation, and a pirate tribe would continually come and steal from them. And they had no way to protect themselves. And he actually picked up two sticks and he fought back against the pirate tribe and sent the message not to mess with his people. And so this dance is a way of honoring not only Makulele, but anybody who fights for what they believe in. And so let's give a big, big round of applause for our fifth grade class as they perform for you the Makulele.
Abençoe, Makulele é o rei da valentia.
Thank you, fifth grade class, for the makulele. That was some fancy stick work there. Pretty great. All right, let's get those little birds out here. It takes a while to get them out. Let's go. Let's get them out there. This is the highlight. This is where it all starts, right here. Yeah, I don't think I even need to introduce this group. This is our kindergarten group, and they're going to dance for you the Little Bird Dance. Kindergarten teachers, we thank you. We know that could not have been easy. All right.
Hey folks, back in the late 1950s, American Bandstand was the rage. Dick Clark was the man, and he brought groups onto television and just totally blew up the whole dance scene. We're so glad that we've got our intermediate ballroom here today. They're going to dance for you a song called You Can't Stop the Beat from the Broadway play Hairspray. So let's give them a big round of applause. Thank you, Intermediate Ballroom. We are now excited to have our first graders hit the floor. They're going to perform for you the National Dance of Mexico. This is the Mexican Hat Dance. Let's give a big round of applause for our first grade classes. Thank you.
first grade classes. Go ahead and head off the floor, back to your seats. You did a great job. A lot of good hand and foot eye coordination. All right, this next song and this next dance, it's got a cute little story behind it. It's a well-known Irish ballad, and it says that it was learned by Colm O'Loughlin in 1925 from a one-legged accordion player in Harcourt Street. That sounds great. I think sixth grade class is ready to go. Let's bring them on out here. Come on out, sixth grade class. They're going to dance for you the Beggar Man Jig. Appreciate that. It was a great dance. And the girls look great with their plaids. Perfect for the Irish jig. All right. Hey, folks, I thought we'd just take a second. If you didn't notice when you came in here, take a look out through those windows right there. Is that not a beautiful view? Big blue sky and that beautiful temple right there. I thought that'd be kind of fun to point out and take a look at. Okay, I'm stretching. Can you tell? All right. We are excited now. We're going to have the eighth grade ballroom class come on and perform for you. This is a medley dance. That means there's several dances in one. There's a swing and a cha-cha. So not only are they learning how to dance these dances, then they're learning how to blend them together to make a medley. It's just fantastic. So without any further ado, we love this song. It's from the hit play, The Greatest Showman. Let's give a big round of applause for our 8th grade ballroom class as a dance for you from now on. Most of these students have never danced before, any kind of dance, before this year. So that's really something. We're proud of them. All right, we've got our second grade team. Where's our second grade classes? Let's come on around the floor. Come on out, second grade team. Here we go. They're looking at each other. I don't go until my teacher goes. That's probably smart. These students are going to dance for you a Virginia reel. The Virginia reel goes way back to Scotland as part of what we call the Highland reel or the Highland fling. And so we're really excited to have these students dance this for you. They're getting themselves all set up. Well, they are, folks. Let's go ahead and give them a big round of applause. Our second grade team dancing for you, the Virginia reel.
Everybody, forward and back. Forward and back.
second grade team, the Virginia Reel.
That was terrific.
This next dance is has an element of danger and risk, possibly even bloodletting. It's quite something. As our girls get ready, this dance hails from the Philippines. It's called Tinikling. And as you can see, it typically involves bamboo, but we don't have bamboo, but we got one by ones. Just as nasty. Actually, probably worse because they get sharp edges and not rounded bamboo. This is always a favorite. I think the girls look forward to getting to the seventh grade just so they can do this dance. All right, they're ready to go. Let's give a big round of applause for our seventh graders, Dancing Lollipop. Just Can't Wait to Be King from The Lion King. So let's give a big round of applause for our advanced performance ballroom dancers.
You're my
Fantastic, fantastic. Good job, guys. Tall guys can dance, a little. All right. All right, this is a big crowd favorite. We got Coach coming on the floor. We know what's coming, right? We get our seventh grade boys out here to do the haka for you. The haka hails from Maori, New Zealand. If somebody came to your tribe and you didn't know who they were, you send out a greeting party. They do the haka. They basically let them know, if you come in peace, that's great. If you come to fight, we're ready to fight. And I've seen these boys do this. I would not mess with any of them. Looks like they're ready. All right, let's give a round of applause for our seventh grade boys doing the haka. Welcome to Pit E. Hey, where's with all the boys?
The rest are still practicing for the haka.
They're still practicing for the haka, okay. Well, what are we going to do while we wait?
Hey, Coach Winatana, can you tell us a story about New Zealand while we wait?
A story about New Zealand? What story do you guys want to hear about?
Story of the haka.
A story of the haka, okay. Well, let's go, eh? A long, long time ago in Aotearoa, or what we also know as New Zealand, there were many different iwis, or tribes. And all the tribes had a leader. And like all great leaders, they were looking for the next chosen one to lead the people. There were many warriors to choose from, but there could only be one. Te Rau Pāraha was chosen as the one to lead the people. He was the one who was responsible to carry on the legacy. So Te Rau Pāraha went on his journey. He fought many battles and conquered them all. But there was one group of warriors that saw Te Rau Pāraha, and they wanted to end his life. They knew they couldn't do it individually, so they took him on together. Te Rau Pāraha sought for help. Whararangi, another chief, helped Te Rau Pāraha. He told them to depart in peace. Te Rau Pāraha was rescued from others and he was able to see another day. Now we have the haka called kamate. The story of the haka is about overcoming challenges, adversity and trials that we all face, with the support of family, loved ones, friends, our leaders, and most importantly, Heavenly Father. With His help, we can do all things. Ladies and gentlemen, the haka, kamate.
School, and they go up against a bunch of other high schools and junior high schools throughout the state of Utah. Let's give a round of applause, because this team actually got the top honors for the top school throughout the entire state of Utah. So a big round of applause for that. And they are now going to dance for you a medley. It's a dance that consists of the jive, the Charleston, the quick step, and the Lindy Hop. These are, without a doubt, our most experienced dancers, and you are going to see why. So big round of applause for our dance competition ballroom dancing friend like me. Facetious here. If you own a Dodge Caravan, apparently there's a baby in the car and you forgot your baby. So we won't say anything about it than that, but you want to go take care of that? Because if you don't, I'm going to go break the window in about 2 minutes. You let me know? Let me know, okay? Okay, so you go back to the car and wait. All right. He's the one that found it. He's going to go back to the car and wait. So, please be called in 1 minute, all right? Sorry about that. Okay.
I'm not too worried for the baby. I know that there are adults looking there and taking care of it, so we'll hope everything's okay. Security's heading out there now. Okay, let's get back to the fun. All right, I think the ladies are first. We'll find out when the music plays. I know there's some bragging rights on the table here, so let's hear it for the faculty.
Yeah.
today, without a doubt. Let's cue it. Cue music. Here we go.
I just need you to get real loose. Get comfortable. Grab your love lines. I'll grab your love, partner. And if you're by yourself, no worries. Just follow after me. Don't do the twister.
If they would just step forward, please, and give a hand wave. These are the teachers that taught the different classes. We've got Coach Smith, Brian Smith, taught the kindergartens into the second grade. Your host, Bonner, Coach Bonner, there he is. Third through the fifth grade. Joe Andreessen, Joe, nice moves, Joe. Sixth and seventh grade. Coach Vinitano. Where is Coach? Coach took care of our 7th grade boys. And Barbara McComber in charge of our ballroom program. There she is. Beautiful. Yeah. So at this time, we'd like to have a closing prayer. And then afterwards, our headmaster, Grant Beckwith, is going to introduce our very last dance, and this is the big one where everybody gets to participate. So if I can have everyone be quiet so we can have our prayer. And we've asked Evan Rutherford to give that prayer for us. Thank you, Evan.
Dear kind, gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for the opportunity to go to this wonderful school and to be able to dance and express ourselves. And please help all of us to get home when the time comes, and please bless that we'll all be able to appreciate the place that we go. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen.
Finally, before I give the mic, before I get the microphone, I want to also mention Jay Clark. He's in charge of our tech guys. All the tech guys, give a big round of applause for Jay Clark and the tech crew. They make all of us look good and sound good.
All right, Headmaster Beckwith.
You know it. Say it with me. It's the Hokey Pokey. Okay, let's roll it. Anyone that wants to dance, let's go.
You put your right hand, you put your right hand, you put your right hand in, and you shake it all about. You do the Hokey Pokey and you turn yourself around. That's what it's all.
Okay, we are also going to invite anyone that can help, especially if we've got some adults in here or teenagers. We're going to try and take this floor apart and put it in these racks with our facilities team. It took them about 3 hours to set this up. 3 or 4 of them trying to set this floor up. We're going to try and take it down in about 30 minutes. So these are 3 by 3 foot squares. They're going to show us once we start taking them down. And then anyone that can help, we'd ask you to help pick up this floor and put them in these racks. Thanks, everyone.